Welcome to Morpheus Chair, the program where you learn to build robots in your comfy chairs. So thanks a lot for the support of the previous video, and in this video what we're going to do is build on top of what we did in the last video. We're going to create a ROS node and some custom messages to be able to access the real Pand&Tilt and the simulated version that we'll do in the next video through ROS with any package or node that uses ROS. And you'll ask, hey Mike, but why do we need that? Well, one of the great advantages of ROS is that it's system agnostic. If you have a topic, any program will be able to access that topic. It doesn't matter sometimes what version of ROS you're using or what operating system you're using, or even if you're in the same computer. If you have access to those topics, it's enough. That's what we're going to do in this video.
To the workbench!
So let's get started. So as always, remember that you have the Git with all the code that we generate in each of the videos. So check it out when you have time, and let's go. So what we have to do, the first thing we have to do is, I'll show you how I've done it. The first thing is that I've created two new files. The first one is this Pand&Tilt client test that we'll see at the end. And then this one, the Pand&Tilt server. So let's have a look. So the Pand&Tilt server, essentially what it does is generate this subscriber for this topic. And when you publish in this topic, Pand&Tilt, which is quite explicit what it does, then we call this callback of this class, and we do whatever we have to do with the data. So in this case, what we do is get the data, which is the Pand&Tilt data, and we move the Pand&Tilt. Yeah, that's the basic idea of this server. Yeah. So let's go step by step and see what's being done here. So the first thing is that we have this init method that has these two inputs. The first one is if it's simulated, and the other one if we're working with Raspberry. So the first one is simulated. What it allows us is to use the same server for the simulated version that we'll do in the next video and with the real Pand&Tilt. Yeah. And we just have to change this to true or to false. So if this is true, then we would initialize this object with the Pand&Tilt move sim class, which we haven't implemented yet. As I said, in the next video, we'll do all this related to the simulation. But if it's not simulated, then it's the real thing. And then before initializing it, we use this if inside Raspberry. This is because we want to do maybe tests in our local computer or in a cloud system like ROS.DS that doesn't have some libraries that Raspberry Pi has. So we do this, and this way we can test things without having to install things that we don't really need. So in case that we are inside the Raspberry Pi, then we initialize this object, which is the Pand&Tilt move that we did the last video. If you don't know how to do it, check the previous video. And we initialize this object with this Pand&Tilt move. As you can see, both simulated version and the real version use the same object, and this allows us to use the same API. And it doesn't matter if it's simulated or real. Okay, so afterwards we create this subscriber that essentially uses this Pand&Tilt message type that we're going to talk in a minute, that it's custom made for this. And then the callback. And in the callback, if we are inside the Raspberry Pi, We call this a Pand&Tilt move object, and we move the pitch and yaw. We will be talking about pitch and yaw, or Pand&Tilt is the same thing. So pan is the yaw and the pitch is the tilt. That's it. And basically that's more or less the class. It's not very complex. Here, when we call this server, we have these two inputs that we are getting from the command line, which is stated here, how to use it directly. So Python, and then just this. So you don't need this, only the Python, and then if it's real or simulated, and true if it's in Raspberry Pi, and false if it's not, yeah? So to launch it, we generated this launch folder and cited this start pan tilt server, which essentially has these three arguments, which is hardware version, if it's real or simulated, and if it's Raspberry Pi, true or false. And then we start the node and we give it the two arguments that we need. That's it, very simple. Another thing that we have to create is the Pand&Tilt message. So we created this folder. It's always with ROS, it's always the same thing. We generate this folder called message, and inside it we put all our messages files. It's a very simple one. It's just fold32 and pan, fold32 and tilt. That's it. It's not very strange. And then in the CMake list, we have to make some changes in order to make ROS compile our message file into the Pand&Tilt classes for Python, basically. This is not magic, it's just we stated in the CMake list. So in the CMake list, we uncommented this for C++11, just for compatibility. But what is related to the messages is this. So we added std messages and message generation packages that we need to do this process. Then add messages, add message files, we added the message here. And then in generate messages, we stated the dependencies, which are std messages that have floats and booleans and strings, this kind of stuff. And I've added this, we don't really need it, but just in case in the future we change this message to something that uses geometry messages. And that's quite it. We add in the package the dependencies that are basically the std message generation, message runtime, and here also. And that's it. We then go to the to our workspace and compile it. So let's go inside our Raspberry Pi. So let me connect. Okay, we go to our workspace and we go to pan and we just git pull origin master. I've already updated, so. Okay, this is an error that tends to happen in Raspberry Pi. Sometimes it just doesn't get the git repos. You just retry and the second time it will work. Yeah, so there we go. So now we go to the catkin workspace and we compile. This is really important, otherwise you won't be able to use the Pand&Tilt messages. Source, so that we can find it, and ROSBack profile, just for the laughs. And that's it. Now you should be able to do it, to use it, okay? So now, once we've done that, we could execute the server simply. So let's execute the server. So ROS launch, Pand&Tilt. There we go. The server. And there you go. So Now we've started. It started all the classes, so you should have the Pand&Tilt ready. So here we have it. So now we have the server running, and we have, as you can see, the Pand&Tilt ready. So now if we connect, there we go. So now we go to catkin source demo setup bash, and we do ROS topic list. We can see that we have the Pand&Tilt, so ROS topic pub Pand&Tilt, and we put some data, for example, tilt, let's put 90 degrees. There you go. So for example, let's put here 45, and here let's put 45 also. There you go. So as you can see, the server is running perfectly. So another thing that we can do is, okay, now why do we need this server for ROS? So the great thing about ROS is that you can create clients for this, and you can call them from other places, from other packages, and the only thing that you need is basically to access the client that then it will publish into that topic. So let's have a look at the client. So the client is even simpler class. We just created a publisher to this topic that uses the Pand&Tilt messages, and it has a method that what it does is get the Pand&Tilt, generate this Pand&Tilt message, and publish it through the Pand&Tilt publisher. That's it. I've generated this your pitch circle test, which is the exact same code as the one we used in the Pand&Tilt move in the previous video, just that we are using this Pand&Tilt client. And what it does is Pand&Tilt, Pand&Tilt move, and the values. It's the exact same thing otherwise. And then I've also generated this raw input Pand&Tilt test, which gets the input of Pand&Tilt and moves the Pand&Tilt. Yeah? So here I've generated this launch file that what it does is launch the server first with the values that we need, and then we launch the Pand&Tilt client. Yeah, so let's do that. So now we're going to launch the client. So for that, we just have to do ROS launch Pand&Tilt control, and let's launch the client. So we don't need this window anymore. There we go. So now it's launching the test for the circle test with, I think, 2 repetitions. Okay, and now we have the input pan. So let's put, I don't know, like 100. And the tilt, let's put 10. There you go. Let's put another one, like for example, 20 for the pan and 100 for the tilt. There you go. So you can see that this is using the ROS topics to publish. So if we have, let me just show you this. And that's it. So here we connect. So here we are doing ROS topic list, ROS topic echo, and the Pand&Tilt. Let me just put it like that. There we go. And if we go here, we now set, for example, 20 pan and 35 tilt. There you go. So it's publishing in the topic. If you want to see something like the test, so we have to echo again, otherwise, there you go. So it publishes into this topic. This will allow us to use simulations, to use other ROS modules. Anything will have access very easily to our Pand&Tilt. It doesn't matter if it's simulated or real. And that's it for today. Please hit that like button if it was useful. And in the next video, we're going to create a simulation so that we prepare the terrain to generate and test the algorithms for face tracking. So the first thing that we need is a simulation so that we can test this very, very fast. And also we'll integrate everything that we've done in the previous two videos in that simulation, and you'll see the advantages of using ROS, because we won't have to code practically anything related to the Pand&Tilt management. We'll only have to do things related to the simulation. Yeah? So until then, keep building.